Now, Jennifer, care to have a little bit of a guess? Who might this be?
Well, when I was at college, I was friends with someone called Joanna, who we called Jobo at the time. And I always used to insist that she'd cheer me up. and to make me laugh, she would do literally anything. And she used to drive me around in this little car. And to make me laugh, if I was feeling a bit down, she would sometimes flash her bosoms at people, right? Which she just couldn't get away with now, but this was different times. And it used to make me laugh so much. We would drive around London. I said, go on, do it, do it, do it. And she'd go, all right, all right, all right. And then drive off, as long as we knew there was a clear road ahead. Sometimes she would stop and she'd run up to a couple. There was a man and a woman, and she'd run up and she'd say to the guy, it's all right, darling, about last night. Everyone will understand. I understand. I understand. It doesn't matter at all. Kiss him and run off again. We'd just drive off. And once she, to make me laugh, decided that she would drive with her leg through the steering wheel. Oh, like this, and we were going through, I think it was Hyde Park, and we were laughing and laughing so hard until we realised she couldn't now turn the wheel. And she was trying to get her leg out, and I think, honestly, we almost died, so I would have to apologise to her for forcing her to make me laugh that much.
There's two things we've got to remember here. Mm. The first, which we just swept over very, very quickly, she flashed her bosoms.
No, it was generally at traffic lights. Just as they went amber, boo-boo, and then off.
And also, let's not forget, gang, this is Jennifer, the puppet master, who's getting her to do these things.
Yeah?
Phil, who have you got to apologise to in there?
I mean, I have a terrible feeling I have to apologise to my ex-girlfriend, Georgia. We went out to a nightclub in Edinburgh called Why Not? Well, it turns out when you go, you find out why not. it was full of disgusting students like us, and they had a special on. It was a cocktail called the Pussy Whip. Wow. Why not? So we had a Pussy Whip jug each, and we were just plastered, and we started dancing on the dance floor really recklessly, and then a bouncer came up to me, tapped me on the shoulder, and he said, well, I've been watching you for a while. I think you should come with me. And I was so drunk, I thought he meant that I'd been dancing so well. And he was a secret dancing judge of the nightclub. Imagine my surprise when I was suddenly out in the cold and a different bouncer threw me out of a different gate. Eventually, we got in a taxi, went back to the halls. In the cab on the way, I did a Scottish accent to the taxi driver, which is not acceptable. But this was pre-Uber, so I never saw anything of it.
Sorry, never do that. No. Never do that in Scotland.
I got back to the halls and I needed to vomit very badly, so I went to the communal toilet in the hallway, and I just went for it, and it went all up the wall, up to the ceiling. I was on my knees, head in the toilet, you understand, and with my pants down at my ankles, because I thought it was going to be a poo. So then I just crawled, like, with my penis and balls dangling around through the shared hallway back to Georgia's room, where we did not have sex. And where I went back to sleep. I mean, the next time I saw that toilet where I had vomited, like, in every corner of that room, it had been cleaned.
I prefer Jennifer's mate flashing her Bristol's, really. That sounded like a better idea, didn't it?
Well done. Yeah. Can I just say, if there are any Scottish cab drivers watching, you're right there. Great to see you. You're watching Dave. Last but not least, Harry, who in there would you like to apologise to?
Sandra.
Does she put up with a lot, Harry?
54 years, I would think plenty of things, yeah. But no, I actually ruined her flowers one day.
Euphemism?
Yeah, I mean, she likes the garden, Sandra, so she's quite a keen gardener.
Yeah.
And I bought a jet washer.
Oh.
To clean the car. Anyway, I got the jet washer. I'm out there spraying the car, and I loved it. I felt really powerful with this. It was a really top-of-the-range one, you know? saw the flowers here. I thought, we'll save water. So I used to like watering the flowers at night. That was my one job I could do. But I liked standing with a hose at night and watering the flowers. I felt quite relaxing.
Yeah.
So I thought, I've got the jet wash. It's easier than... So I thought I'd just... And as I did them, the tops came off all of them. Lovely flowers, and Sandra was actually looking out the kitchen window at the time and saw me do it. So I was caught bang to rights. No dinner that night.
Is there anything else that you should be apologising to her for?
Well, we were watching the racing on TV a little while ago, and I said, Sandra, my horse is running quick, come and watch it. She went, oh, great, you know. This horse was called Shake 'Em Up Harry.
Oh, OK, is he good to put money on?
Yep.
I might have a little flutter.
And she went... I didn't think it was called that, your horse. She said, I thought it was called Movie Star. I went, oh, yeah, but no, we've changed the name of it. She thinks I only had one horse, you see, but I've actually got 10. So,
she's got no...
No idea. They all cost you money every week. But I don't stop me buying her new bags or whatever she needs or shoes.
I'm imagining Sandra standing in the shoe shop like this or somebody kind of just nails the shoes on.
Sandra, yeah, new shoes.
Well, this is intriguing, guys. Who could it be? Who is our mystery guest? Lou, have you got any thoughts, my love?
Don't think so, Mel, no.
Don't worry, that's fine. So, is it Jennifer's Bezzy, Phil's vomit victim, or is it just Harry's wife, who we did admittedly see you arrive with? I can tell you that the mystery guest is... Jennifer's bosom buddy, Joanna Bowen! Jobo! Hang on. Jobo, are we going topsies on today or topsies off? We're going topsies.
No, topsies on. Don't flash them.
Oh, I mean, you said... There was never much more than this anyway, so I wasn't that excited.
Now, she's given us her side of the story, and
yes.
I have to say, she painted you in quite a bad light. What's your side of the story? This is what we need.
Well, it's true, because when Jennifer really, really laughed, it was such heaven to make her laugh. I was a bit always trying to recreate the moment.
Yes.
I became a bit like a battered wife, really. I was always trying to recreate the good times. So the bar just kept going up. And I still think I need an apology, really.
I am sorry, but I've got a lot of mileage out of it. Right, take your clothes off.
Oh, ladies and gents, Jobo! Amazing.